Hi guys, and welcome back to the third day here at Goodwood Festival Speed 2018. Today is a Saturday, so it's extremely busy. We've been walking around the event for a few minutes and it's a complete change from the Thursday and the Friday. There is so many people, meaning it's so difficult to get shots for you guys. But we've come out of the event again and bumped into these two beasts behind me. Agera N and Agera 4, which is a final edition number one of two, Agera RS.
This is crazy. The event is honestly rammed today and there is nobody around here at the Super Vettura RV where they're keeping the cars. And this final edition is amazing. The other day I really wanted to have a good sort of look at it, but it's been so busy that we haven't been able to have a proper look around. But the spec on this is crazy. I didn't really rate it at first. This one being two of two Agera RS, so the final one in production. But it's beautiful. I thought at the start, being grey sort of carbon doesn't work amazingly, but if we can look down here, I don't know if it picks up on camera for you guys, but there is a diamonds in the paint. It flecks in the light and it looks stunning. I'm really not sure if that picked up, but it is beautiful. I absolutely love the RS. It's a shame they're ending this, but I'm guessing they're carrying on with the Regera, which has turned up at this event and was in yesterday's video. Looks insane. But then we've got the standard Agera here, Agera N. I covered this at London Motor Show. It was owned by a guy called Neil, who now owns the Agera RSN, the blue one that's been going up the hill. So what an upgrade, and his Speciale just chilling there as well. Amazing cars to start off the day, but I can't wait to see what else we find today. Our daily routine, we've come over to the supercar parking to check out what cars are here. Today obviously is never going to be as good as yesterday, with 9 Zondas parked up and then the HB Barchetta turning up overnight as well. But it isn't too bad. We have Porsche 918 here. This is actually the same 918 that turned up on the Sunday last year. It is amazing to see this car despite it being non-YSAC and of course having the penis wheels. But there are also some incredible cars around this car park, so I'll cut to a quick cinematic, check out what's here. There's so much going on here at Goodwood Festival of Speed that you miss so many cars. So this section we didn't even know existed. We're just walking through the small dealers that are here promoting their stuff. And wow, Bistral Blue 720S running some amazing rims, as well as a lowered Performante by the same company. There are some incredible cars here, I'll take you through them. Check out the spec on this. To my understanding, there was only one Bistral Blue 720 in the UK, but clearly not anymore. Running an amazing plate, 7E. I bet that's worth as much as this car. Some beautiful, beautiful rims on here with the yellow calipers. Looking amazing with the contrasting black roof and of course the wing up, because baller. Absolutely amazing looking car. And next to this, equally amazing, lowered Performante, running some gold rims. Looks absolutely stunning with the Italian stripe down the side. Black on the mirrors, not carbon though, but then the carbon on the back here looking absolutely amazing. Gold engine through the engine bay. But, oh, it's got different rims on the other side. That's pretty cool. But that is not the best thing here at this stand. Check out this. Koenigsegg CCXR edition, one of four in the world and the only right-hand drive variant in full carbon, looking amazing with the engine up, doors open. These doors are the coolest doors on any car for sure. You'll definitely miss this car at the event. So hidden away by the dirt section over there. The Sanix is beautiful GT2 RS. And then an AMG GTR in the corner there. There's so many hidden gems at this event. And I'm so glad that we've decided to come exploring to see this absolute beast. Anniversary of Goodwood Festival of Speed this year, so they have on display on this lawn some of the best cars from the last 25 years, and I must say there's some outstanding cars. Starting off with this McLaren F1, previously owned by Rowan Atkinson, Mr. Bean, and I must admit he drove it like Mr. Bean. I think this thing's been written off like 3 to 4 times. So many new body panels, it's definitely not original. But it's recently been sold and it's still sold for a stupid amount of money because these cars are so desirable, so luxurious. I think this is my first time seeing this one. Looks amazing. But carrying on round, we have this Nero Ferrari F50. This is the best spec I've ever seen, and this made me fall in love with F50s back in 2015 at Salon Privé. One of the first events I ever went to, and definitely one of the best because this thing turned up. It looks absolutely amazing. The only thing I don't like is it's got tints on the windows, but they're not too bad. But the best thing about this car is that you can see right through the engine at the back. What a view, incredible. I'd love to follow this thing one day. But there's so many cars on this lawn. We've got a Spyker in the corner, and then a very questionable spec, Koenigsegg CCX. Very weird rims. Not mad on this, to be honest, but it is cool because it is an egg. We have an MC12 Corsa, one of 12 produced, and this one I'm so happy to see. It was at Le Mans the other week, and I even said, oh, I really want to see that car, and here it is in the flesh. Absolute beast. I definitely have this over an Enzo. I know it's quite controversial, but the Enzos aren't track focused. Then carrying it on, we've got a Veyron, the same one that was at London Concourse and London Motor Show, so I've seen it quite a few times. This time actually being parked in handling mode, which I really rate. Carrying on, we've got Jaguar CX75. I'm pretty sure this was the one actually used in the film Spectre. It's got the plate Roma, which I'm pretty sure was the one used, but I don't know why they didn't put this into production. Absolute beauty. And first time I've ever seen it with a wing up. This wing is huge, really extended out on those carbon struts. Looking great with that black plate. I really do rate black plates on these cars. Absolute beauty in orange. Only a few of these cars are actually allowed in this color because it was used from the film. So the other one that I've seen before was actually in blue. And I've seen one in Coventry Transport Museum being in silver. So this is a very rare color on this car. Moving over, we've got Peter Saywell's Porsche 918. In a very questionable sort of green stripe livery with the penis wheels, of course, being non-YSAC, but it does look great. Not many 918s go for these sort of bold abstract decals, but this one pulls off very well with a black contrast because all the 918s have this green stitching, and then I think most of them have these green calipers as well, so it really ties it in very, very well. Unless we have a LaFerrari here and an Enzo. But what is good is that the Enzo's there and the MC12's there. This thing looks so much better. Definitely have that over the Enzo. And if you thought the madness was over, it's certainly not. Here we've got the Koenigsegg Agera Final Edition, this one being the Vader, number one of two. So we've actually seen both of them in this video. I don't think I've covered this yet, but we also have a black CGT to, you know, add to the madness, because there isn't enough insane cars already. But this is what I am absolutely obsessed with, Lamborghini Reventon. I've actually seen this one before in the Super Futura dealership. It looks insane, inspired by the fighter jet and based on the Murcielago. It is such a crazy, amazing and aggressive design. And finally, this isn't even the last car on this lawn, but we have the Zonda Oliver. This is the best Zonda I've ever seen. Saw it driving in London the other week, and I still cannot believe that I've seen it. It's incredible. This is actually owned by a young lad who can't even drive yet, but it's finished in silver with carbon running all the way through. It's actually on this bonnet. Some amazing Italian stripes. all these details, such as the headlights being in carbon, the wing mirrors, massive, massive roof scoop stretching all the way back down the fin. And then what is crazy about this car is a double wing on the back. As if this massive knockoff wing was not good enough, we have a little one down the bottom as well. Crazy. I've heard that this was based off a Zonda F, taken back to factory and redone in this insane design with all the different accents on it, such as the big wing, the roof scoop, extra fins, everything. It doesn't look anything like a Zonda F, it's unrecognizable. Just been editing up today's video. I've got to the end and realized I forgot an outro. So I really hope you guys have gone on to enjoy today's video. If you have, please make sure to smash it a like and subscribe, because these daily vlogs are grinding. It is a lot of effort. I respect everyone who does daily vlogging. It takes a hell of a lot of effort every night. I'm sat here on the editing table grinding out the footage for you guys. I'm really, really enjoying it though, and the feedback so far has been amazing, so thank you guys so much. But anyway, if you have gone on to enjoy today's video, please make sure to smash it a like, subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you tomorrow. Cheers.